If you lose or destroy evidence relevant to your case, you may face sanctions for spoliation of evidence. A former radio DJ tried to shake off spoliation sanctions in the 2017 case, Mueller versus Swift. David Mueller worked as an on-air radio personality for country music station KYGO in Denver. In June of 2013, he attended a meet-and-greet before a concert performed by pop sensation Taylor Swift. The two posed for a photo, and things went downhill from there. Swift alleged that Mueller reached under her skirt and grabbed her backside during the photo op. She said the proof was in the photo. The next day, Mueller's bosses at KYGO called him in for a meeting to discuss the groping incident. Unbeknownst to them, Mueller secretly recorded the two-hour conversation. KYGO fired Mueller the following day, partly because Mueller's bosses identified inconsistencies with his story. First, Mueller said he never grabbed Swift. Then he said the whole thing was a misunderstanding. At some point after being fired, well after having contacted his attorney about potential legal action, Mueller edited the recording from his KYGO meeting down to clips. He sent only the edited clips to his attorney. Mueller ultimately sued Swift for tortious interference with his employment contract, seeking $3 million in damages. Swift countersued for assault and battery, seeking a symbolic $1 judgment. During discovery, the Swift camp requested a copy of the complete, unedited recording from Mueller's KYGO meeting. Mueller never produced it. According to Mueller's deposition testimony, the unedited recording was lost when he spilled coffee on his laptop. The external hard drive he used to back up the recording had also stopped working at some point. Swift moved for the court to sanction Mueller for his spoliation of evidence. Specifically, she asked the court to give the jury an adverse inference instruction that the unedited recording was harmful to Mueller's case.